So in this video, I'm going to talk about header tag. What is header tag? What's the tag structure? And how to add header tag in HTML? Hello friends, I'm Shivani Goyal. Welcome in WsCube Tech. So let's start with what is header tag. Header tag, also known as heading tags, which are used to separate your headings and the subheading on a web page. They rank in order of importance from your H1 to H6. And H1 is usually your title. That is your big heading. This is your H1 here. And for this particular big heading, now we have another heading. That is your H2 here. H2 is the subheading of your H1 here. Again, you have H3, which is the subheading of your H2 here. So by this way, we can use this particular tag here. These are our heading tags here, which we can use in our web page just to do differentiate between our headings and subheading. So header tag improve the readability and SEO of a web page. Now, what are the tags we have? We have 6 different tags in your heading tag. Start with your H1, we have H2, then H3, H4, and we have up to H6. These are the 6 different type of heading tags here. Let's start with H1 tag. H1 is the title of particular post. They are usually keyword centric, focused around the big idea of the page or the post and craft to grab a reader's attention. Let's suppose this is your post page here and this is the title of your particular post. So that particular title you can write in your H1 tag, or by default it is in your H1 tag. Next we have H2 tag. Any subheading if you want to give these all headings in your H2 tag. These are the subheaders that classify the main points of your paragraph and separate sections. Consider using semantic keyword related to the big idea in your H1 while also helping the readers easily find the sections they want to read. Again, we have H3 tag. So these are the subsections that clarify the points made in the H2 further. Alternatively, they can be used in the formatting list or bullet points. So these are the tags available here. Now, this is the tag structure. For example, this is your title which represents the big idea of the post that you have to return in your H1 tag. After that, you have first point, then you have to write in the H2 tag. Again, you have second point, you have to write in H2 tag. Then you have subheading of this particular tag here. You have to write this in your H3 tag. Again, for H3, you can take subheading in your H4 tag. By this way, you can create your tag structure and you can write your post in this particular way. Now the question is, what is H1 tag? Now, let's understand H1 tag in detail. In H1 tag is the first and the most important heading tag in the structural hierarchy of a page or a post. This is the topmost heading of your particular page. It typically notes the page or the post titles. H1 tag should always be at the top of your page before the rest of the content. So that's why H1 tag is very important, because H1 tag is the first point of content which your users use before reading your complete post. For this particular H1 tag, you have to write H1 tag in this way, that this is the summarized form of this particular content. When user read your H1 information, so they can understand that this particular information is the summarized form of the content. After reading your H1 tag, they consider that your whole content is relevant to this particular headline. Now, the question is, how many header tags are supported by HTML? HTML is a language here, and this particular language we can use for writing our web pages. And in this particular language, we have 6 different type of header tag. And in these header tag here, you can see that this is the biggest tag. This is the biggest heading here. After that, you have H2 tag, which is smaller than or the subheading of your H1. Again, H3, which is the subheading of H2. H4, which is subheading of H3, again H5, which is the subheading of H4, and H6 tag, which is subheading of your H5. So HTML support up to 6 header tags here from H1 to H6, and you can use to structure your page as needed. They can be stylized visually according to your brand, and with the exception of the H1, you can have as many of these tags on a web page. On a single web page, you can use only one H1 tag here. After that, you can use as many H2, H3 and other tags as possible as according to your content. Now, the question is how to add header tag in HTML. This is the example here, how to add this particular tag with the help of your HTML coding. Here you have starting H1 tag and this is the closing of H1 tag. And this is the result which you are getting on your page here. Okay. So adding your header tag in HTML is fairly simple process. Here this is notated by your H1. So you can add by this way. This is the very simple process here. Let me explain you with the help of one demo how you can add your H1, H2, H3 tag in your particular post. For this, let me take example of one of the website here. This is the website we have. In your website, we have one particular post. This is the dashboard we have. In that particular dashboard, let me visit the particular post. In your post section, let me click on all posts. Here we have, this is the title of your post. Okay, this is the post we have. First of all, we have this particular heading here. Okay, for this particular heading, let me click on that. This heading is in, by default, this particular heading is in your H1 tag. After that, if I want to add any further heading, how can we do that? Here, let's suppose here I want to create one heading. How can we do that? We have to simply click on this add block option here and we have to click on heading. Okay. By default here, you can see that you have only H2 heading option available here because this particular heading is your H1 heading, and after that, any heading you can add, that is your H2 heading. Let's suppose here you can add H2 heading, that is e-commerce website. Let's suppose this is your H2 heading. If now you want to take any subsection of this particular website here, if you want to add paragraph, you can write your paragraph here. Again, after that, if you want to add any another headline, you have to simply click on that. You have to change your headline and you have to write here another subheading. Let's suppose this is the subheading. So here you can see that traditional, this is the subheading of your e-commerce website, and e-commerce website is the subheading of this particular H1 tag, or you can say your header tag, your title tag. Okay, so this is the title of this particular page and these two are the subheadings here. By this way, you can create your heading in this particular post. By using this particular heading here, you can see that you can make your post as effective. Here you can see this is your H2 tag. After that, this is your H3 tag. And if further you want to create any another heading here, you have to use your H3 tag. By this way, you can use your tag here. So this is a demo example here, how you can add H1, how you can add your tag in your website post. So now, the question is, what is the difference between your heading tag and your title tag? Here you can hear two terms. One is your title, one is your header. Okay. In case of heading tag, here we can see that for that particular post, we have heading tag. That is your H1 tag here. And for your complete website, we have title tag. So let me show you how. Example here. Title tag is for complete website. Title tag is known as your meta tag here, and this is shown at the head of the web page just like this, and that is not the part of your actual content. You would not see the title tag on the page, and the title you can show on your page, that is your H1 here, and the title which you see on the top of your bar just like this, this is your title here. So this is the difference between your title and H1. Your title tag, which is visible on your search engine result page, on your web page title, that is your title, and your header, which you can see on your web page title, on your web page title here. This is your H1 tag here. Okay, so H1 is visible on the page are it usually most prominent text that tell the visitor what to expect on that particular page. And the title tag, which help the search engine to understand what your content is all about. For the H1, which is the heading of the page, Google gives it more attention because it is the largest thing user can see on your web page. Now, these are some H1 composition guidelines. The H1 header can be used only once on the page. The length is usually up to 50 characters, and you must have to include your keyword in your H1 tag. The H1 subject intersect exclusively with what is discussed in the text section. Whatever be the primary keyword you decide, you must have to mention your primary keyword in your H1, or you can say the title of your page. So this is all about your header tag. In our upcoming video, we will learn more about on-page SEO activity. So thank you so much for watching this video.